This silent desert region of Tabas is like an open-air museum with many attractions. Attractions that hold the same charm as the history they represent. The variety of beauty that hides in this land can entice any traveler, and the story we want to tell today is to help remember or perhaps revive places with no remaining inhabitants. Abandoned villages with intact old city structures are scattered all over Iran, and even though this fact is a bit sad, it has turned them into popular tourist attractions. The village of Pirahajat is one of them. As soon as you enter the village, it's rather pleasant atmosphere, and the fragrant aroma and the colourful sight of new blossoms strike and surprise you. Since Pirahajat is on the rim of the Great Salt Desert of Iran, 100 kilometers to the northwest of the city of Tabas in South Khorasan province. Over the years, the villagers built newer and sturdier homes right next to the old city structure, since their old homes were losing their structural stability. If the almost 800-year-old village of Pirahajat were a ring, then its jewel would have to be the turquoise dome of the Pirahajat Mausoleum. The name of the village, the elder who grants wishes, is probably derived from this mausoleum, which was built in the 13th century during the Seljuk period. The most eye-catching structure in the village is the historic castle, a two-story adobe and mud brick building that overlooks the intertwined streets of the old and new village and the green fields and gardens that surround it. Villages can be abandoned for many reasons, but the one thing they all have in common is the slow agony of abandonment. In the case of the village of Korit, which is 20 kilometers to the south of Tabas, that feeling is multiplied.
روستای کوریت قدیمی ترین روستای شهرستان تبس هست به لحاظ قدمت و بزرگترین روستای تبس هستش. از نظر تاریخی همپایه تاریخ خود شهر تبس هست و روستایی است که در واقع به قول کاشناسان میراث ماکتی هست از یک تمدن گذشته.
The historic village of Korit, which is more than 1,500 years old, was brought to ruin by an earthquake in 1979. These days, some of the remaining survivors of that earthquake, who were mere babes at the time, are trying to restore it to its former glory.
در جایی که ما الان ایستادیم در حال حاضر راسته بازار کوریت به حساب می اومده و در پشت سر شما مسجد کوریت هستش، در دست چپ ما قبرستان کوریت که خودش قبرستان خاصی هست، موسوم به قبرستان اسپردنی هست.
Graveyards can tell us a lot about our past, shedding light on the famous, or in this case, unknown individuals who are part of our national heritage. They hold the secrets that local historians have yet to uncover.
This small arched adobe structure is a grave. In the old days, many caravans used to go by the Kurit village. Whenever one of the caravan members passed away, they would bury them in such graves. Their remains would then be relocated after a couple of years and moved to their hometowns or where they had wanted to be buried. Now, in the local dialect, they are known as Espordani graves or surrogate graves. No one knows why some of them were never relocated and why this graveyard became their final resting place.
The most intact buildings include The Abanbar or underground water reservoir at the entrance to the village where fresh and cool water was stored. The public bathhouse that's completely restored and is ready for use, and of course the only caravanserai of Korit that now serves as an eco-tourism hotel. These days, the village of Korit is known for this beautiful and cozy place that seems to have been frozen in time, providing us with an opportunity to live, if only for a few days, where the old inhabitants of Korit lived and perhaps feel how they felt. This is Gulnar Farnoodi for Iran.
Iran's wealth is not only limited to its extremely rich culture and fossil fuel reserves. In fact, there is a limitless wealth hidden even in a fistful of sand. Is called Aran Vapid Gol, a small city 200 kilometers away from the capital, Tehran. It begins from Iran's central desert and goes all the way to the south. On the edges of this side of Iran's central desert, known as Maranjab, is a road that leads us to an absolute bright view, Maranjab Salt Lake.
شمال آران بیدگل قرار داره و جاده دسترسیش فقط از آران بیدگل میباشد و این دریاچه حدود 50 کیلومتر در 60 کیلومتر مربع استش که ما سنداج کردیم تا عمق 5 متری هم نمک وجود داره و خلوص نمک اینجا بالای 98 هستش که نمک استاندارد جهانی حدودا 97 هست ولی اینجا از میانگین استاندارد جهانی بالاتره.
Desert, salt has been produced through an evaporation process and is the remaining of a sea which once used to cover the whole area and went extinct millions of years ago. This gigantic spread of white color is one of Iran's biggest mines, which more than 80% of the salt consumed by Iranians is extracted from here. Moreover, this salty land is filled with minerals such as boron, magnesium, and potassium, which can be found all over this soil, layer after layer.
غیر از نمک خوراکی اینجا مصرف میشه، فلزاتی هستش که پتاس هست، لیتیوم هستش و منیزیوم که بحرالمیت و اگر ما در جهان نگاه بکنیم که میگن نمکش منیزیوم خوبی داره که 2.5 گرم در لیتر هستش ولی اینجا با 2.7 گرم بر لیتر هستش که خیلی مرغوم به صرفه است.
Now the road takes us towards north, a 60 kilometers distance to the northern end of the salt lake. At this stage, salt has created an unbelievable scenery. An ecosystem consisted of water, salt, and minerals exclusively in Iran, and maybe even in the world for its harmony and symmetry. Salt is so powerful in nature to the point where it can even create geological structures. One of those examples is a salt dome. Sometimes the salt minerals steaming under the ground push the upper stone layers so hard that enter them vertically, and then the steam comes out. This mode creates bubbles or domes. The geological history of this salt dome dates back to 600 million years ago. This dome is massively big and stretches 3 kilometers towards north. In addition to the white trace of salt and crystals which cover small salty streams, one of the most interesting spots of this landscape is a sinkhole situated in the middle of the lake and its depth is unknown. Twenty minutes away from the dome, we reach the end of our white journey. Hos Sultan. Probably the most interesting point about this amazing scene is that it's not totally natural and was built in 1882 next to Tehran Qom Road. Today, this white scenery covers 240 square kilometers. The thickness of its salt layers reach 20 meters and are separated from each other with different colors of clay from brown to gray. Some experts have considered this phenomenon as a lagoon, and its name can be seen among Iran's lakes. But the most important point about this stunning natural basin is its ability to reflect light because of the high amount of salt crystals being dissolved in water, which creates a gigantic mirror. Bolivia is the only country in the world which has a natural mirror and is comparable to Hos Sultan. The experience of traveling through the white salty path in this part of Iran is for sure one of a kind.